Hey my beauties, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to be doing a chit chat, a little get ready with me so I can get ready for my baby's birthday. So let's go ahead and begin with this transformation. And I also want to give a huge shout out to my Nexus fam because they are going to be sponsoring today's portion of the video. So as my first step, I'm going to be using this Prep and Protect leave-in spray with hyaluronic acid. It's literally the perfect product to begin with because it's going to help lock in our hair's natural proteins. It's also a weightless moisturizer and it easily detangles our hair. It boosts our shine. It adds softness. Like, it just preps the hair for everything. So it's also great for like heat if you're going to be adding heat, so which I am. So this is going to be perfect. So now I'm just going to go ahead and split my hair because I am going to blow dry it really quickly. As you guys know, I always like to use this. And so after I am done blow drying it, now we're going to begin with the hair tutorial. So we're going to split our hair down the middle, and then after that we're going to split it off to the sides to create two sections. That way we can create two little buns. So as you guys can see, just, you know, taking a comb so that way I can split everything. Now I'm going to tie the hair in the back so that way it stays out of place, and then I'm going to put one side off to the side as well with a little elastic band so that way, you know, it doesn't get in the way of the other one. So now for our second product, I'm going to be using the ultra fine hairspray. It's an ultra fine mist that provides all day lightweight hold while also leaving texture in a soft matte finish. So you can use it with your hair down or when you're putting your hair up. Like for instance, right now I want my baby hairs to stay in place, to not move around, so that's what I'm doing. So after I am done applying that, I'm just gonna put my hair in a little ponytail and tease my hair. That way it adds volume once we start creating our little buns. So now taking the elastic, I'm gonna go ahead and do one more round, but instead of putting my hair all the way through, I'm only gonna do it halfway so that way it can create the little donut. And I'm gonna take the rest of the remaining hair and put it around the elastic band so that way it can hide it. And then I'm gonna take bobby pins to pin everything down. And this is super easy. You can do it this way or we can try it the other way, where I'm going to show you guys now the second option of how to create these. So again, taking my hairspray, I'm going to go ahead and spray that, put it in a little bun, leaving one side so that way I can tease it. And then after I'm done teasing it, I'm going to put it halfway through. So now in this time, instead of putting the hair around, I'm going to take it inside the little mini donut and then go around so that way it can just create more fullness if you have really ultra fine hair. But again, it kind of works both ways. You can do it one way or the other. And so yeah, I just kind of left that option for you guys to decide how you guys want to do it. And I'm just going to pin everything down. And once we have our two little donuts now, which you guys can see that this is how they look, and don't mind the front because we are going to be hiding it with bows or like a headband. Next, we're going to take in again our leave-in spray because I am going to be adding heat. We're going to be curling our hair. You can pretty much leave it straight if you want, but I decided to curl it. So I'm going to go ahead and curl all of my hair away from my face. So that way it just creates the curls in the same direction. So once we are done curling our hair, we're gonna do the same thing to the other side. So now once we have our curls, now I'm gonna take the comb through finishing mist. And we're gonna apply this all over our curls. And the reason I love this finishing mist is because it has a medium hold, so it's going to allow our curls to last all day, but at the same time, but it still allows our hair to be brushed and glide effortlessly. So it just makes our hair very beautiful, and I love just using this as the finishing touch. So once we're done with our hair, to add the finishing touches, we're gonna wait until we are done with our makeup. So now we're gonna move on to our makeup. So I just primed my face and now I'm going to be mixing these two foundations, and I'm just gonna be applying them all over my entire face and then just blending it all out. And I love mixing these two foundations because, I don't know, I just feel like they work together. So it just makes my face look a lot more flawless, like photogenic, and at the same time last all day because of the Dose of Colors foundation. But anyways, once we're done with that, we're gonna move on to our concealer. As always, I'm always using the Shape Tape concealer. So I'm gonna apply that and then take my contour stick from Makeup by Mario and apply that. And by the way, I'm gonna be leaving links to every single product that I use down below in the description box so that way you guys can go and check out. But anyways, once I'm done blending out my face, I'm gonna move on to a smaller brush. That way I can blend out my nose contour and all that. And obviously I am using a lot of my brushes from the Dream Collection with Sigma. So that will all be, like I said, linked down below. Moving on to the eyes, I'm going to be only using this little palette from Dominique Cosmetics. So I'm going to start out with that transition shade, applying it on my crease, and then I'm going to move on to the really hot pink color, which is called Boss Babe, and applying that as well in my crease, kind of like flickering it out, kind of creating like a wing type of effect with the shadow. And then I'm going to take the lightest pink shadow so that way I can apply it all over my lid. But anyways, yes, I'm just applying that all over my lid and then going back in there with blending brushes to blend everything out. And then taking my Araceli Ojitos Perfectos liquid eyeliner, I'm going to be lining my eyes so that way I can create a nice winged eyeliner. And then once I'm done with that, I'm just gonna go ahead and hit it with mascara on my lashes so that way I can prepare them for the falsies. Next, for my brows, I'm gonna take the Pomade Brow Pomade from Benefit Cosmetics, and obviously using my Dream Brow Brush to apply this. So I'm just gonna go ahead and fill in both of my brows. And once I'm done filling both of my brows, I'm gonna move on to setting my entire face. So taking a translucent powder, I'm first gonna go ahead and just use my sponge to kind of blur everything out again and then go ahead and set it. So that's what I'm doing here. I actually really like this technique of letting my face sit there for a second with the products and then going in with the powder. I just feel like it works best. I don't know, let me know if you guys have tried it, but I feel like it does make a difference. So anyways, I'm just gonna go ahead and just set all of my entire face, and then I'm gonna move back to my eyes because I'm gonna work under my eyes. So now taking this eyeliner from Translucent, it's their Intenso eyeliner. I'm gonna be using the clearest one, or at least whitest one, and then taking Boss Babe with a flat definer brush, I'm going to be applying it underneath my eyes. And once I'm done applying that, I am going to also take the transition color with a mini E25 from my collection, and that way I can just blend it all out and then finish it off with a little bit of mascara on my bottom lashes. Now, to give a little bit of warmth to our face, I am going to be taking this powder from MAC. It's the one called Give Me Sun, so that way I can just apply it where I did apply the contour stick, so that way it can just warm up the face like I said. And then for my blush, I'm going to be taking this hot pink one from the Murillo Twins palette, so that way I can just make my cheeks look very rosy. And then for my highlighter, I'm taking this one from LYS, so that way I can just be glowing, and then setting everything with my MAC Fix Plus. And once everything is set, I'm going to take my Birdie liner in the color black, so that way I can go over my eyeliner. And then taking my Birdie lashes in the style XXX, I'm going to be applying the full strip, so applying it on top of my Birdie liner. And then to finish off the lips, I'm going to be taking the Murillo Twins lip liner. You guys know this is my ride or die. This is literally my third lip liner, guys. And now for my liquid lipstick, I am using the one from Dose of Colors, but I did go over it with a lighter one from Dose of Colors as well. That way I can just make it a little bit more lighter and nudish. And now adding my final touching headband piece, I am all done. Hopefully you guys love this Minnie Mouse inspired makeup and hair look. I had so much fun creating this, and Jaylene loved it. She couldn't stop staring at me. But anyways, my loves, thank you so much for watching me. And thank you again to my Nexus fam for sponsoring today's video. I love you guys. And with that, I will see you guys all in the next video. Bye. Mwah.